Early show tonight on Will sold out. There is a very good chance there's going to be a sellout for the late show. Just a handful of tickets left downtown tomorrow night.
But if you want them, you should get them.
Immediately.
Don't, that's not to discourage you from getting them. That's to encourage you to call now.
I don't want to throw any show business jive at you, but I think what I'm saying is don't dilly-dally. And tomorrow, tickets available for both shows, but they'll sell out too. Especially with that rain, a lot of people are going to be going because Jake's really good.
It is
in the
indoors.
Rain.
It's totally indoors. It's an indoor venue out in Vernon Hills. So if you're homeless right now, a great opportunity to stay out of the rain would be to come to the comedy show.
That plug is so well timed because earlier this week we distributed radios to every homeless person in Chicago.
That is super
timing.
Yeah.
Facebook Me, a guide to having fun with your friends and promoting your projects on Facebook. Dave Awl is the author. And Dave is here, and we discussed poking. There was a question, Dave, about super poking. Mm-hmm. Do you have to know a secret handshake, or is that all part of your Facebook application?
It's just an application that you install. You know, you can find it, but probably someone will super poke you before you have to go looking for it.
Okay, all right.
Now, can I ask Jake a quick question? Because it's
only if it's about Facebook.
Well, it's not really. It's
no,
about
ahead,
cooking.
Dave.
But when you make that smothered shrimp dish, do you have to use tiny little pillows to smother the shrimp with, or
no.
Is there some other chloroform on a rag?
They're already deceased.
Yeah, Dave, honestly, Dave, seriously, maybe get out of the house, right?
I mean, maybe you're on Facebook too much. He needs to learn Facebook. Maybe we can work out a barter system.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't say that I know as much about cooking as you know about Facebook, but if you're up.
All right, now I have another legitimate Facebook question.
Okay.
So when I initially signed up for Facebook, because, you know, I lost the bet, and the listeners insisted that I go on Facebook. I did it under an email that's here at the Tribune Company, as opposed to the other 27 secret email accounts that I have.
Sure.
So, for instance, my phone, my mobile universe, here in my left hand for people watching the radios right now, I can't access it because this email doesn't dump to this phone. So, is it difficult to go back and change my profile?
Not at all. You need to go into your privacy settings. You can do that from the blue bar on any Facebook page.
Okay.
And you know what I'm going to start doing? I decided to do this when we were talking about pages. I'm going to start giving footnotes to what chapter everything is in my
book. That's a good
idea. That's chapter 4 of my book.
That's a very good idea.
And the pages we talked about earlier, that's chapter 11 of my book.
That's a very good idea.
People can look it up, play along at home.
Right. Tam, you have a Facebook question?
No.
All right.
No, actually, I do.
Hey, by the way, did we delete the Tim's Hip Surgery Facebook group yet? We should get rid of that group.
The hippest group on Facebook.
That was a powerful group.
That was a group and a page the same
thing. Oh, that was on our website. I'm sorry. You can go to WGNradio.com and you can still link into Tim's Hip Surgery, which, by the way, on our website is still going on.
I do have a question.
Okay.
How do I deal with, I don't know how many friends you have, Steve, but I don't have that many.
Well, it's like 700, nothing like Jake, but I just got on the thing an hour ago.
How many friends do you have, Jake? Do you want to tell us how many friends you have?
1,000 or so friends, something like that.
Oh, okay, that's good.
Mark
Most of them are other comedians, though. I still have the same problem as I had on MySpace, where everybody's trying to get me to come to their show, and I'm like, no, shut up, you come to my show. So I've got a little bit of a problem. But when I get my page, then I'm going to sort my fans to my page and keep my friends my friends. And what about this other thing, though?
Whoa. I had a question.
Tim's got the talking stick.
Man, you just
filibustered. You asked me a question.
Yeah, but then
you asked me a question.
Steve to ask a question.
I'm telling you. And I thought your question to me was that
no
question.
Idea.
That was just subtle eye contact.
I had no idea this was going to get this ugly.
I looked towards your
By the
way,
Mark Sapelsa, my friend Mark Sapelsa from Channel 9, has the limit. He's got the 5,000 friends.
Yeah, well, that limit will go away, but yeah, he needs the page. Tim, what were you going to ask me?
Just
ask me something.
Is there any way to distinguish between really good friends and people that you don't even know that you just assign them friendship status?
See, that is an awesome question, and I never say because I'm too old to say it convincingly.
Right there. Let's see if you ask an awesome question.
Well, how about we get the answer on your awesome question?
I don't care about the answer to the
question. You're walking around high-fiving yourself.
I just want him to know that that was a good question.
Well, see, this is the difference between you and I is because I care about the answer. Go ahead.
So could you separate it into friends I care less about?
Yes. One of the best features on Facebook, one of the best things on Facebook that most people don't realize is there, is what's called friend lists.
Yes.
You can create a list just for your family, for your coworkers.
What chapter is this in?
This is in chapter 3. Thank you.
Unbelievable.
And are you following along?
Remember that about
I have one list called Trusted Friends, which are just for the people who can see my mobile phone number. I have another list called PIDRK, which stands for People I Don't Really Know. And this way, you can
and
assign...
And this is a grown man.
But can they tell, can people tell what group that
no,
they're in?
No, no one knows what list you've put them on. And this allows you to choose who can see what parts of your profile. So you can choose who can see your contact information.
Sure.
You could create a photo album of, like, party photos from college, and only your college friends can see that, and not your boss.
Should I friend Bernie Madoff? Oh, wait, that's not a legitimate question at this point.
No, no one should friend him.
All right. What's the question you get most often, and maybe the one that spurred the book?
Boy,
have
I don't
we not covered
I'm not
it yet?
Keeping statistics yet. So,
well, one, it comes up a lot.
I don't have a number one question. But I would say the privacy questions come up constantly because a lot of people, especially if they're new to Facebook, they don't know which parts of their profile are public or private. And that's something everyone should learn. Some of the stories you read in the news about people who get in trouble, it's because they didn't realize that if something was posted on their wall or in their status, they thought only their friends could see it. And they don't realize that if they're in a network like the Chicago network or the LA network, everyone else who's in that network can see it too.
Can you customize your privacy settings to a point you feel completely comfortable?
Absolutely.
If you're spending some time and you're really figuring out what you want people to see and not see.
Yeah.
Learn don't you think, I mean, honestly, I mean, God bless you for writing this book and God bless the work you're doing. But this
God
is the,
bless you for telling people God, how to get books.
And this is the and this, but this is the this is the idiotic part of Facebook to me. Continually. There's some stuff that you don't want people to see. And basically,
why
it's
would
most
you
of the stuff on
stuff?
Facebook.
Why would you put secret stuff on Facebook?
But it's just, it's so counterintuitive because even for what you do and I do and Tim does, like, people can put pictures up that maybe are you, Jake, in women's clothing, and that's not for public consumption necessarily.
No, it is. That's why I put them up there.
All right. Well, you're probably right about that as
well. No, but I'm saying why are you putting up things? I always sort of feel like once you're putting something on the internet, forget it. It's like you might as well plaster
Thank
it on the
you.
Side of a bus.
I say that in my book. This is what I say. An ounce of discretion is worth a ton of privacy settings. In other words...
Is that like that PIDRK thing you did a moment ago?
Think before you post something, because anytime you post something on the internet, no matter how good you are with privacy settings, there's always a chance that it could be seen by a wider audience than you expected. So if you really don't want something to be seen, don't post it at all.
All right, so here's what I want to do, because this will shock you. We're out of time.
Oh.
but here's what I want you to do. Rick, let's look at next week, or because the week after I'm out of town for a couple of days. Next week at some point, I want you to come on the show, and we're just going to let people ask questions.
All righty.
Would they ask Jake this question or Facebook questions?
No, I think Facebook questions.
Will I
probably
be on the show?
Ones.
I won't probably be on that show.
Well, you would be if you interrupted less.
All right.
All right, then.
Ooh. I just want to say one thing right now. Not everyone gets more famous when their sex tape comes out. I just wanted to. That is just something that people should remember going into the long weekend.
All right. Quick traffic and a weather update, and then we're cool. All right. Quick traffic and a weather update, and then we'll take one or two more questions from the panel of Facebook dopes that we've assembled here in the studio.
Nothing personal if you're holding.
Stand by. Ashley the intern. Facebook Ashley the intern. If you have a question, you're welcome. Rick. If you have a Facebook question, you're welcome. Dave Stewart lives online when people think he's writing a newscast. Apparently, you can get this book everywhere. And AWL, Dave Awl, is the author. Facebook me. And am
See,
I your
he spelled it again. He's so brilliant.
Am I
good.
Your Facebook friend?
Good.
Yeah, well, we can be. As like, boy, I go home, it'll be the first thing on my agenda. Find Steve and friend him.
Something there, about the way your eyes darted around right after you
was
said the
shifty?
First thing you're going to do.
Was
yeah, it
I
seemed
shifty?
Like it wasn't totally truthful. But
I might visit the washroom first.
Yeah.
So it might be the fifth
home?
Thing I do.
Yeah. Right.
You
right.
know, but I'll get there.
Listen, I respect that. Do you have a final Facebook question? Jake, who will be at Zany's tonight and tomorrow night. Late show tickets tonight. Tickets for both show available for the next few minutes tomorrow night.
I don't know. Can you come back to me on a final Facebook question?
Unlikely. Tim.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah,
I have.
I want to go back to Jake and see if he has a good question.
So you would like to give your floor to Jake.
Once you post a, let's say
the
you
gentleman from Rochelle yields time to the gentleman
from Iowa.
Let's say you post a video on Facebook. What are the ethics of then? You posted your video. It goes out to all your friends. That day, Jake posted a video. Then the next day, you say, well, not many people watched it. I'm going to repost it. Can you just keep hammering them with the, hey, this is my video. I posted my video. Don't forget my video.
You can do it every so often. If you do it too much, people will think you're a jerk and defriend you. But, like, once a week might be reasonable. Mm-hmm. Like, look at how often your friends are posting things. And think of it as, like, you're merging into a highway from an on-ramp. And, you know, find the right time, feel the right time to repost it.
Steve, mm-hmm. Steve.
Tim Cook?
I thought of my question.
Go ahead.
Yay.
Oh, awesome.
Thank you, Jake. when people, and Jake will relate to this, when people invite you to their comedy show, you're at Vernon Hills tomorrow, downtown
yes,
Zanies.
Yes, and I might put that on my Facebook. I might say, hey, I'm at Vernon Hills Zanies tomorrow.
And you have three options, right? They give you three options.
Isn't I don't invite as an event. I have it. I should be creating events and inviting people
but
instead that, of just putting in my status
what,
update.
But that's what Bob... when you invite as an event, they give you three options. The ones will attend, maybe, and ignore, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you can also remove from calendar.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's news time now at 6:30 on the Voice of Chicago. News Talk 720 WGN. Your news is sponsored by Honquest Fine Furnishings.